You need to be familiar with labels if you want to get the most out of your Gmail organization. So this is your complete Gmail labels tutorial. Hey friends, I'm Tasia Custode and welcome back to my YouTube channel where I share tech tips, app reviews, and a ton of Google tips. Today, I'm going to show you how to use Gmail labels. You ready? Then let's go. So when we're talking about Gmail labels for beginners, it only makes sense to start by explaining what exactly labels are. It helps to think of labels like really organized filing drawer system. So picture a filing cabinet, and then picture beautifully color-coded file folders all neatly organized. But cooler yet, you can apply multiple labels to one email for further organization. But more on that later. For now, let's learn how to create a label in Gmail. There are actually a couple of ways to do this, but one of the easiest is to simply click on the plus symbol to the right of the labels list here. And by the way, if you do not see this main menu on the left, you can click on the hamburger menu icon in the top left to expand that main menu out. So we'll click on that plus symbol, and in this pop-up, we can enter in our new label name. So really think about what type of organization works best for you, because you can literally name your label anything. So as an example here, I will create a label for top clients. Now don't worry about the sublabels option right now. We're gonna talk about that a little bit later. Let's instead hit create. And now you will have that newly created label on the left-hand side listed under labels. And while we're here, we can change the color of our labels too. If you guys watch any of my content, you know I am a visual learner. I love color blocking my GCal, I color block my Keep Notes, so labels to me are no different. So to change the color of a Gmail label, you can just hover your mouse over the label and then click on that three-dot menu icon that appears. At the top, hover over the label color option and simply choose a color from the drop-down menu. You can even pick a custom color here, by the way. And this is also where you'd remove or change a color as well. So while we're exploring label colors, the three-dot menu icon is where you can make some other changes as well. So if you need to change the label name, you could edit the label right from here. So now that we know how to create a label in Gmail, let's learn how to add the label to an email in Gmail. And there are, of course, a couple of different ways you can do this. So right from your inbox, you can select the emails you'd like to add a label to, which can be one or multiple emails. And then at the top, select the labels icon, or depending on your inbox, it may look like this with the actual word labels. No worries, it's the same thing. So either way, you're gonna select that labels icon or labels, and then select the label from your list. Or this is another way to create a label. So if you hadn't created a label yet, you can do it right from here too. So for now, let's add it to an already created label. Alternatively, you can also add a label to an email right from an open email. So when you're inside of an email, it's the exact same steps. You're gonna click on labels at the top and then select the label you'd like to add. If you have a ton of labels made, you can actually take advantage of the search bar at the top and just quickly search for the label that you want. Now keep in mind, you can add multiple labels to an email for even better organization. So simply select all the labels you want to apply and then click on apply. But you know, I am all about shortcuts. I love to save a click whenever you can. And wouldn't you know, you can drag and drop to apply labels too. So from an open email, you can simply drag a label over and boop, drop it on your email. Boom, your email will now show that assigned label up at the top. By the way, you can hit the X on the label to remove that label if you want. But you can also drag and drop from your inbox. So again, clicking on the label and dragging it over to the email and simply dropping it there. This adds the label to your email while keeping your email in place in your inbox. But let's say you want to add a label to an email, but then you want that email housed within the label and out of your main inbox. Well, then you simply drag and drop the email to the label. So it's just the reverse of what we just did. You'll click and drag that email and drop it on the label on the left menu. Now you're gonna notice that doing it this way has removed that email from our inbox here. So if we click on that label on the left-hand side to open it up, you're gonna notice that email has been given that label, but it's also been stored within that label, just kind of like as if you've put it in a folder. So this, by the way, is a quick way to find emails you've stored under a label. Just click on the label on the left side, and only those emails that have that specific label will be shown. You're also gonna notice that in this label view, you don't have your label appear on the email itself. That's because you're already in that label view, so Gmail figures you don't really need that extra visual cue. But you can open up that email though, and you're gonna notice the assigned label does appear right at the top for you. So now let's learn how to create sub-labels in Gmail. These are also known as nested labels. So there are a couple of ways to do this, of course. So let's maybe say that you're getting a ton of emails under a certain label and you find that you need to organize that a little bit further. So I could organize my Google label a bit further as an example here. So let's create a sub-label for this. The quickest way to do this is to click that three-dot menu icon to the right of the label and then click on Add Sub-Label. Here you'll just enter in the name for what you want to call the sub-label. But we can also get there by clicking on the plus symbol to the right of the labels list. And maybe I want to call this Google Photos. And then we're gonna toggle on the Nest Label Under option. And now here in this dropdown, we'll select the label we want to nest this under. So I want to organize this with my Google label. So now I'm creating a Google Photos label within the Google label. It's like a folder within a folder. So let's click on Create. And now on the left-hand side, Google Photos sublabel is listed under my Google label. So you can add as many nested labels as you want. There really isn't a limit. So if you have too many listed here, you can simply collapse the label by using the arrow on the left of the label. But I'm gonna expand that for us again because I actually want to apply this sublabel to an email. So let's use our drag and drop method, and I will drag and drop this sublabel over to this Google Photos email. And now that label's added to the email and it shows both the label and the sublabel. So we've got a top level layer slash the nested label. So this is a really great way to stay organized because just like we learned to click on a label to view the emails within, we can do the exact same for sub labels. So we can click on a sub label and all the emails with that nested label appear. We're really drilling down into that niche organization. By the way, yes, you can create a sub-label for a sub-label and do that to infinity if you really wanted to. But before we go wild on labels, if you're finding this video valuable, I would really, really love if you give it a like and then hit subscribe to my channel for more Google goodness. Can you believe that there's even more to talk about when it comes to Google? Who would have thought? So that's how to create labels in Gmail. And now I want to hear from you. Did you find this tutorial helpful? Let everyone know in the comments below. As always, thank you so much for watching. If you like this video, well, I want to know. So give it a like, a share, or leave that comment below. You can click right about here to subscribe to my channel and here and here for even more Gmail content. It's true. Thanks for watching. See you next time.